No mai, haere mai, welcome and warm Pacific greetings. I'm Kate, and during this video, we're going to korero about a condition called POTS, Postural Orthostatic Tachycardia Syndrome. Since getting COVID-19, have you had problems standing without feeling well? Perhaps you feel faint when you stand up, shaky, foggy, trembly, weak, or even nauseous, or your heart beats really fast. If so, you may have POTS.
So in terms of the symptoms of long COVID, what we found here in Aotearoa exactly mirrors what's happening overseas. So the most common symptoms are extreme fatigue, brain fog, aches, muscle aches, headaches, joint aches. And then the next most common symptom would be POTS. So a measure of orthostatic intolerance. So things like dizziness when you stand up, which isn't just as simple as it going away after a few seconds, but is really quite debilitating.
Many people with long COVID have a form of dysautonomia, which we explained in video 3. This is when our automatic nervous system doesn't function properly, so we have problems with many of the things our nervous system controls naturally, like temperature regulation, digestion, and heart rate. POTS is a common form of dysautonomia, and is when we have changes in our heart rate and blood pressure when we stand up. Remember, orthostatic means upright or standing, and tachycardia means fast heart rate.
So I have chronic fatigue, this is really major, and brain fog, which is difficulty processing lots of information and thinking, basically. Memory loss, and I have difficulty translating my thoughts into speech, and I just can't find the words. And then there's my POTS symptoms, which I just can't handle the impact of gravity. My body can't, and so I get blood pooling in my abdomen and legs and feet and hands. A raised heart rate on standing and elevated on sitting. Blood pressure issues, both going high and low. Woozy, lightheaded and unsteady on my feet, a sore chest, an instant headache on standing, heavy legs on standing, and a bee sting-like pain in my lower legs and ankles on standing.
This can have a huge impact on daily life, and at times it can be mistaken for anxiety. POTS is easy to test for, and there are ways to manage it, which we'll talk about soon. While it sounds complicated, it's quite simple in terms of what's happening in your tinana, your body. Basically, when someone without POTS stands, because of gravity, the blood in the body wants to move down towards the feet and away from the head. But the brain senses this and makes the heart beat faster and harder, as well as making the blood vessels in the lower part of your body tighten. This keeps your blood pressure at the right level and gets the blood all around your body and to your brain to stop you from fainting. Your heart rate then slows again, and all this happens in a matter of seconds. Our bodies are very clever, but when someone with POTS stands, the body's mechanisms don't work properly, and too much blood goes to the feet and not enough to the head. The brain tries to fix the problem by telling the heart to work harder and beat faster. This works to a degree in that it may prevent or delay fainting, but it also causes symptoms such as feeling foggy and weak.
So I then suffer from anxiety, because, which I've never ever had before, never had a problem. A panic when I'm standing after maybe about 30 seconds without meds, which then is caused by adrenaline just pumping through my system, trying to get my heart to get my blood back up into my brain, and lack of oxygen in the brain.
So how do you know if you have POTS? There is a simple test called the NASA Lean test, which involves taking your blood pressure and heart rate when lying down resting, and then again every minute when leaning against a wall for 10 minutes. You can download detailed test instructions and a link to a resource that also explains how to interpret the test via the link in the video description. You can do a home version of this just by taking your heart rate using a smartwatch, a pulse oximeter, or the good old-fashioned manual method with two fingers on the pulse of your wrist. When you're standing, if your heart rate increases by over 30 beats per minute, or goes over 120 beats per minute in total, and doesn't come back down again within a minute or two, then you could have POTS. Some doctors apply slightly different figures, especially for children, but the main thing to remember is that if you have a large and lasting increase in heart rate and you get symptoms when you stand, then POTS should be considered. It's important to note that blood pressure is also important. And if your pulse or blood pressure drops dramatically, this can indicate a different form of orthostatic intolerance, an intolerance to being upright. If you would like to do this home test, please do so with a whānau member or friend with you to help you in case it makes your symptoms worse or you feel faint. The good news is that POTS can be treated, and there are a number of things that you can do at home that can help you. The first step is salt and electrolytes. Doctors recommend increasing salt in your diet by 10 grams a day and drinking 3 litres of water a day. Many others with POTS have found electrolytes helpful, and you can buy some great versions without added sugars, colours, or preservatives at health shops or pharmacies. Or you can make your own. We have included a recipe to make your own in the information via the link in the video description. The second is compression clothing. Wearing compression clothing on your legs and tummy helps the blood to pump around the body. The best medical compression stockings are fitted to your body and can be found at certain pharmacies, or you can order standard compression clothing online. The third is to avoid triggers, such as prolonged standing and heat. Heat dilates your blood vessels and makes the blood pooling in your legs worse. Using air conditioning, fans, cooling mats, cooling vests, or simply wearing cooling clothes can help. Lie down regularly with your legs up and put a chair or stool in the shower if you find showers trigger your symptoms. For some people, digesting a large meal can cause a drop in blood pressure, so eat smaller and more frequent meals to help with this. The fourth is medications. There are a range of medications used for POTS. For example, if you have low blood pressure, which drops when you stand up, a medication called midodrine helps to increase your blood pressure. Others have used beta blockers to lower their heart rate or blood pressure. This will require the care of your doctor or health provider. There are some cardiologists who specialise in POTS, so discuss this with your doctor and ask for a referral.
For POTS in particular, I have compression wear that I wear that compresses and constricts my blood vessels. I have medication to help constrict the blood, to slow my heart rate down, and to retain sodium, and have extra salt and water. By extra, like 6 to 10 grams of salt and 3 liters of water at least a day. I have the breathing, and also my breathing physio has introduced me to the CHOPS protocol, which is from the Philadelphia Children's Hospital for the treatment of POTS. It's a slow exercise program, which is incredible. So it's getting my body moving but not over exhausting me, and I do it at my own pace, so if I'm not if I'm having a bad day, then I don't do it.
often if we treat a breathing pattern disorder, it can reduce a lot of the symptoms that are experienced through dysautonomia, such as things like postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, or POTS, if you've heard of that before. And what we've found is that by actually treating breathing pattern dysfunctions, by trying to reduce that respiratory rate, or the rate at which you're breathing, we can control some of the dysregulation in your autonomic nervous system.
In summary, POTS could explain a number of your long COVID symptoms. There is a test you can do at home. However, talk with your health provider to discuss your symptoms and get confirmation. Using our other four tips, salt and electrolytes, compression clothing, avoiding triggers, and medications can help, sometimes a lot. Ngā mihi. Thank you for watching. Please do get in touch if you have any questions. And if you found this video helpful, please share it.